You're continuing this conversation around the group fees. I was just wondering, I was looking at the other group fees that I have taken with my teams in the past, and obviously I had so when I had these large group fees with my own teams, almost every time I was not the one who was clicking the picture because I was not the tallest. Obviously there were other guys who were tall, much taller. So invariably it was some very junior person who would volunteer to click that group fee. And, you know, the volunteering would come with a lot of hesitation because I was around. And, you know, it's pretty obvious that the person who is clicking the group fee is the one who's going to be in the foreground and where all the spotlight is going to be. And that volunteering would come in with a lot of hesitation. And then I would prod that person and say, obviously, because you've got the longest hands and you're the tallest, it makes sense for you to take the picture. And then it would come. So in an organizational context, how would you take this analogy further?
Sarani, I get where you're drifting towards skills, but my larger point is to say intent is very important. Okay. And I see one of my very close friends once upon a time, Ashish Gakre, also as one of the participants on this call. And I want to take this opportunity. Ashish, are you there? You want to just unmute yourself, Ashish?
Yeah, yes, Sahil, I'm here.
Oh, lovely. Thanks, Ashish, for joining. So, Harini, I want to take the example of Ashish because, you know, in the last couple of months or maybe the last 1 or 2 years, we have seen a lot of HR forums come forward from, you know, multiple forums have come to light. But if you ask me, one of my earliest memories of HR forums was when Ashish actually started something called HR Shapers, right? And he got the whole universe of HR professionals together on one platform. And I think that is where the whole idea starts. It's about the intent. It is about saying, I am not insecure as a leader. I am just one of the members. I am absolutely comfortable getting thousands and lakhs of people together on one platform and collaborating. Now, the moment that happens, Harini, what ends up happening is people like Ashish may be enablers, but I personally know of multiple people who have, you know, maybe just taken a break from their jobs, who become consultants, who become HR consultants, who have played various learning roles. And through the platform that Ashish has created as HR Shapers, and I'm sure there are many other bodies like HR Shapers within the HR fraternity who do that. But the whole intent was people today are making great amount of money. They're making massive business just because a platform like HR Shapers and others have connected them so in such an easy manner. So I think skills that you spoke about of saying having a long hand and being able to take a selfie and a leader encouraging someone to take it forward is good. But also at the same time in corporate India, if you see someone who is better skilled as compared to others, leaders or managers generally end up becoming extremely insecure. Becoming extremely possessive, becoming extreme, saying this is my team member, or they don't let them come under the limelight. They keep them in their shadows. So I think this whole intent of being very open, and I'm sure a lot of HR, like HR Milestone, a lot of other HR organizations, not-for-profit organizations that many of us are part of, are doing the same thing. Today, I asked this fundamental question, right? I want to just spend 2 more minutes on this because this whole brand association is something that people are very, very stuck onto. And from a brand association point of view, people end up saying, and you know, many people invite me to be on their managing committees of various HR forums, HR bodies, or come and talk to them. And I ask them a fundamental, simple question. Today, everybody is doing a webinar. Everybody is talking about these learning sessions. Fantastic. But what is your USP? And if there is no USP to any specific HR body, then the whole question is, why aren't we collaborating? Why is there no consolidation happening? Why is it not a situation where the largest bodies in the world, if their purpose is common, why can't the entire strength come together? And to link that to corporate India is my whole question of gig economy. Today, you may say, and we've discussed this on multiple forums and multiple HR events, to say, yes, gig is good to do this, that, and the other. But my fundamental question is, if I work for Coke in the morning, will Pepsi allow me to work with them in the evening? Because gig is not about exploring a passion around photography and doing an HR job and being a foodie. That's not gig to my mind. Gig to my mind is when corporate India can have enough amount of data confidentiality and security in place and trust with employees that if he works, he will draw the line or she will draw the line, she will draw the boundary, but let's consolidate, because with the way the world is going, to run sustainable organizations, you need to consolidate. And sorry, I'm going back to Ashish, but I just saw a recent case where he's run a series of getting all HR leaders of various forums together on one platform with a very another close friend, RK, on Proventus HR, doing it along with Ashish. And I think that's a brilliant idea, right? Getting people together, consolidating, and therefore for corporate India, what does it mean? How do we draw consolidate? We read about that, a lot of search agencies dropping their boundaries and coming together as one team, multiple leading search agencies, it was in the newspapers the other day, and actually helping people who have lost jobs in the time of COVID. So I think these are some of the disruptions we should keep our minds open to as we explore our skill sets and our career.